Hi, my name is Henk. Welcome to my channel. Today I want to talk about European designs and collaborations with WeKnife / Civivi. That's Knife Collector here. Many of you will know that Civivi is a subsidiary or a sub-brand of WeKnife. And WeKnife is a manufacturer, a Chinese manufacturer of high-end premium production knives. WeKnife started in 2016 with their own brand, and in 2017 and all high-end premium knives. And in the end of 2016, they also decided to add a budget line to their lineup of knives. But this budget series was still around $100 or up. So not everybody could afford to buy their knives. So in 2018, WeKnife decided they needed another budget line, and to distinguish this budget line of the WeKnife Premium Series, they decided to start a sub-brand called Civivi. And Civivi offers budget-friendly knives, starting at around $50 or a little bit less or a little bit higher, and now they offer knives between $50 and $100, and then the WeKnife brand itself offers knives from $100, $110 up till in general $280, but they also have some special editions with very limited production runs or very high-end customization work, and they also offer knives from $500, $600 or maybe even higher. So I have been working for WeKnife for several years. While I was doing this, I had a lot to do with knife makers and designers. So I also got to know very talented European knife makers / designers. And I pulled a couple of them into a collaboration with WeKnife / Civivi. So it started in 2018. In the summer of 2018, two European designs were introduced, and those were the WeKnife Ferox, I think it was the 812 number, and the WeKnife Wasabi, and I think that was the 813. The Ferox is a big sturdy knife designed by Gudi van Poppel, and Gudi is a Dutch knife maker. Actually, he is a very good friend of me. And it's quite a personality, very extrovert. His work is most of the time influenced by Southern European history, in knife making history. And he makes a lot of tactical designs. The Ferox is not so much influenced by Southern European design elements, but it's purely a hard-use tactical knife. As Gudi likes to tell, I do not make knives for pussies, I make knives for real men. So this is a prototype, and this prototype is customized by Gudi himself for me. So this is the WeKnife Ferox, but remember, it is a prototype and a customized prototype with a lot of details. And as mentioned, this is a real hard use knife, so very sturdy, frame lock, full titanium, M390 blade. Then at the same time, the WeKnife Wasabi came out. This is also a prototype. I will show pictures in frame from the production varieties as well. I got to know Rafal from BRR Knives, from Rafal Bresky, and I learned to know Rafal during the annual knife show in Belgium, in Jean Blou, and I liked his work very much. The wasabi is a kind of larger gentleman's folder. It's a very clean design. It's a Wharncliffe, and this is designed after Rafal's custom wasabi. It's a very nice, beautiful, elegant, slim design. Then a year later, I learned to know Alessandra De Santis, and she has the design company Hydra Design. And I learned to know her, and we worked together on several projects like website design, European Knife Association, and she had designed the Hecate, or maybe you call it the Hecate or Hecate, but it's Greek, Hecate. It's a mythology, it's from Greek mythology. And the Alessandra is specialist in tactical defense, security, that kind of stuff. So she designs a lot of tactical utilities, tools, that kind of stuff. And the Hecate is a design of her. And this came out last year. I think it was introduced during Blade Show West. And the Hecate is also, just like the Ferox, a very big, hard-use, sturdy, tactical knife. Again, this is a prototype. And Alessandra received a lot of credits for her design. Right now I'm working on an article about Alessandra, her designs, especially the Kiri EDC. She did another collaboration with WeKnife for Civivi, for the Civivi lineup. Very soon this article will be featured on Knives from Europe, www.knivesfromeurope.com. And this is a prototype, and this is another prototype. Again, I will show you pictures in frame of the final production versions. Very, very nice design, very nice knife. And then also last year, I learned to know Miguel Barbudo from Spain. Very talented Spanish knife maker, especially specialized in hunting, bushcraft, and tactical fixed blades, but he also does folding knives. And I learned him to know, I think, 2017 or 2018. I have a custom Bocao, and this is the production this is a prototype of the production version of the Bocao. It's a very big, sturdy knife. It's with a Spanish window lock. I hope it shows on camera. Let me show it. This is the window lock. It looks a little bit like the Buck. I think it's the Buck. I forgot the name. Buck Vantage. I don't know again. I forgot. But this is the Spanish window lock. It's quite similar to a back lock. Only this cutout will lock the knife in place in this slot, in this cutout. So very sturdy knife. Very strong locking mechanism, and I like the Spanish influences in this design. Then I also learned to know Markus Reichardt, who's a German knife maker. He makes beautiful fixed blades, specialized in hunting, bushcraft, that kind of stuff. And he came to me with a design of a pocket version, a folding knife version of one of his fixed knives. And again, this is a prototype. And this is an awesome knife. This is a slip joint, very clean, very clean design. It's the Grand Forcé mechanism, so it needs a lot of pressure. So it is a non-locking knife, but it needs a lot of pressure to unlock it. And then you, so it's very safe using this knife as an EDC knife, also for hunting, that kind of stuff. It's rather big for a slip joint, but again, this is a very clean design, so also it has also properties of a gentleman's knife. Markus Reichardt, name to remember, German knife maker. And then at the same time, I learned to know Tony Tietze. He made this design. Again, prototype. And it's also available in fixed blade. These are called the Scopio and the Reazio. It's in fact the same design. Both are prototypes. And Tony is a very talented young knife maker. I think he's 23 now, 24, 22, something like that. Very nice guy, and he is so talented. You will hear a lot of him in the future. So this is one variety of the Scopio, and this is another variety, also a prototype, and really a gentleman-like knife with a clean design, but with a compound grind, so very complicated to make this. By the way, this one is called the MRF or Markus Reichardt folder. So, as you can guess, I'm very proud about our European designs featured by Weknife/Civivi. I'm very grateful I could have a part in this. Check out Knives from Europe, www.knivesfromeurope.com, because I'm working at more articles about our European designers, not only for Weknife and Civivi. Very soon there will be articles with and videos. For example, I've scheduled an interview with Miguel Barbudos from the Blocau. I've scheduled an article and interview with Alessandra De Santis about her work. She has more collaborations to come, also with other companies. Just to name a few, Ostap Hel soon will be announcing collaboration with manufacturers. We are scheduling an interview with him right now. For example, Kombu Gregor from Poland. He's well known for his beautiful photos he posts on Instagram, but he also collaborates with Bestek. Actually, this afternoon I'm doing an interview with him. So a lot more to check out at www.knivesfromeurope.com. So I hope you liked this video, please give it a like. If you are not subscribed yet to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. Your support means a lot to me. And if you want to get notified each time I upload a video, also press the notify button so you get a push notification when I uploaded a video. And within some time, I'm working on it, I will be doing live streams with questions and answers and that kind of stuff. And I'm working on some guides about the knife hobby. So stay tuned. Thank you very much for your attention. Hope you liked it. That's it for now. Bye bye.